welcome back. It's Chris from Huckabones Equipment today. We're here talking about the Kubota On Tour truck. So it usually this time of year, it's going dealership to dealership for their open houses and other Kubota events. So you'll see it at the curling events. You know, Brad Gushue, Kubota sponsors him, Gord Bramford concerts, stuff like that. You'll see it all there. At the Pinty Cascar series, you'll see this truck as well. You'll see the driver Keith and his wife everywhere. They're great sponsors for Kubota. If you have any questions, he's usually fantastic at answering them. His answers may not be right, but he'll at least give you an answer. So, So Kubota's been doing it for 8 years now. The reason it's here today is for COVID-19. They're kind of going around to the dealers, giving them a big thank you for being open while everything was going on. They're giving away face masks and stuff. Unfortunately, we're not allowed to advertise or anything, but it's great for the guys in the back, for techs or mechanics kind of idea. It gives them a morale boost kind of idea, and it was great to have them here. Yeah, so it's got your toys, your sandboxes, digital touch screens. It's fully loaded. Usually they bring the latest and greatest equipment, whether it be excavators, skid steers, tractors. It's a big show whenever it shows up, but Kubota does it upright. And touch base with about Keith. Keith's been with Kubota Canada for coming up on 10 years now. He volunteered to be driving the Kubota truck 8 years ago, and he's put on about 2 million miles, means he's crossed Canada 20, 30 times. He's seen everywhere from the Northwest Territories out to PEI, BC,
Newfoundland.
He's been on the ferry, so he if you want to know about Canada, he's the guy to ask. He's better than any tourist guide. In the future, you'll see Keith here, nice big display with lots of fanfare from Kubota. But if you do see it on the road, give him a nice big honk and a nice big wave, and look forward at your local Kubota dealerships in the near future.
So today, with the KOT truck being here, we decided to have a barbecue. So we're cooking a brisket from Uncle Jim's Meats. We brought the cook out with us, Graham. He can tell us exactly what he did to it.
So with the truck showing up today, we got all excited and we got brisket. We like it spicy here at Huckabones, so what we decided to do this morning was use a little bit of the Big Green Egg Nashville Hot. Brings a little bit of heat to the equation. And their awesome ancho chili coffee mix. What I'm going to do is I'm going to crack this thing open and let you have a look at it. Can't smell the flavor, but I'm telling you, this is something that you're going to want to try at home. Feeding 20 people, but then...
So we've got a couple pounds of brisket here.
Big slab of meat.
We got a big slab, big old slab of meat. So it's been on there since about 8 o'clock this morning. It's been on for a few hours, just getting nice and delicious for us, nice low and slow.
What temperature are you trying to keep it at?
We're trying to keep it around 250. Keep a nice low heat on it. Let it warm up and get nice and soft and tender. Break down some of the thicker meat fibers. So by the time we get to lunch hour, we got a nice soft juicy brisket for all of us to chew into. We've also thrown in a bunch of apple wood into the bottom that's been slowly smoking all morning. So hopefully that's permeated the meat, and then we've got some nice flavor to dive into later. Coming up next, what we'll do is we'll end up tin foiling that and leaving it with a little bit of our sauce just to keep all that moisture in there, and again just build that flavor. So by the time we get to lunch, all we want to do is eat and try not to work for the rest of the day.